vibrant carriers aloof in spring breeze. So this is a limited time event of Genshin Impact 4.4. As the years and approaches, the annual Lantern Rite is about to begin. As is customary, you and Paimon return to Liyue Harbor once again, and as expected, you encounter some familiar faces. So let's go to the quest. And the Aureoles bask in spring. The heavens present auspices. So of course, we already read this. Here we go, I think. And we're going to the Liyue Harbor. Here we go. So once again, guys, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Okay, here we are. And we're going down more. Whoa, okay, so this is the area for the lantern rides. That's nice. Here we go.
Ka-ching! And Charlotte!
And Charlotte!
I never thought she'd see you two together!
Nice to see you again, Traveler and Paimon.
Oh, we're not interrupting anything, are we?
Not at all. I wasn't in the middle of an interview or anything. I was just asking Miss Kuching about purchasing a kite.
A kite? Are you buying some regional specialties to bring back to Fontaine?
Fontaine?
Well, yes. And it seems you haven't heard yet. The theme of this year's Lantern Rite is kites.
Oh, I see.
Oh, so that's why Paimon has seen so many floating in the sky.
You didn't see that.
Liyue Harbor is always changing. So it is only fitting that Lantern Rite should change in turn. The Qixing believes it would benefit Liyue to build on our own cultural foundation by embracing the technologies of other nations. After all, it is said that the stones of another mountain may serve to better polish one's own jade. So, Ningguang organized a private meeting with Miss Charlotte to ask for her help in fostering cooperation with the right people.
Okay.
In the end, we decided to combine Liyue's traditional art of kite making with Fontaine's mechanical vertical lifting device.
Mechanical lifting device? Sounds pretty impressive. but don't kites just use the wind to fly? Why would you need to add something mechanical?
Yeah.
Well, you've actually just answered your own question, Paimon. How high and far a kite can fly depends as much on the weather conditions as on the skill of the person holding the string. But as soon as there's no wind, you can only flail about helplessly like a sweet flower Madaka out of water. Experience doesn't matter at that point. Exactly. Liyue is now a nation ruled by humans, after all. It's about time we had the power to make a kite fly, don't you think? Plus, the easier we can make it to enjoy, the more people will want to participate.
Sounds awesome.
Right? I also thought it was a novel idea. Plus, it shouldn't cost much to do.
Yeah.
With Miss Charlotte's help, everything has gone smoothly. Our new mechanical kites are already available to purchase from a stall in the harbor. We're having trouble keeping up with demand. We also gave quite a bit of thought to the price. We didn't want it to be too much more expensive than a traditional kite.
Cool! Turns out you two and Ningguang like playing with toys just as much as Paimon!
Toys.
Toys? They're not exactly toys. You see, Miss Kuching, that does seem to be everyone's first reaction. Although kites are one of our most time-honored cultural relics, outside of their use in certain ceremonies, I suppose they're considered playthings more than anything now. But to me, there's so much more than that.
Yeah, what's that?
Think for a second about how remarkable it is that a flimsy paper kite attached to a string has the capacity to touch the sky. It is this slight piece of paper that also carries the weight of Liyue's cultural traditions. There's an old poem that goes, "O kite born of paper, flying true and sound, a lone traveler wanders, just waiting to be found."
Okay.
past, poets from Liyue used kites to symbolize a feeling of longing, or evoke the peacefulness of idyllic rural scenery. If the people of today can derive enjoyment from this activity, they will not only be more likely to better appreciate the tradition, but also to pass it down to the people of tomorrow.
That's the Kuching we know, always thinking five steps ahead of anyone else.
Well said, Miss Kuching. I've learned quite a bit myself.
As long as you're willing to listen, I'm happy to share. I also know quite a lot about the various folk traditions related to kites. For example, whenever a kite blew away, people would say it was the adepti that summoned the wind to take it away as an offering. That way, you can turn an unfortunate event into an auspicious one.
What about something more fun? Do you know anything like that?
More fun. Let me think. Oh, I suppose we should first talk about how kites are made. It's another one of our precious forms of traditional craftsmanship. My grandfather told me that back when he was a boy, children learned the art of kite making step by step from their elders. First, you use the thin strips of bamboo to construct the frame. Then, you draw a design of your choice on a piece of paper, paste it onto the frame, and tie on the string. Then, you look towards the sky and release the kite to soar among the clouds. Some people write down certain names or desires on their kites, cut the string, and let them fly free. Others may place particular thoughts or meaning into the design itself.
Are certain designs associated with certain meanings? I'm gonna jot all of this down.
Well, for example, kites in the shape of a butterfly typically symbolize freedom, happiness, or the desire to break free.
Fascinating. What else can you tell me?
The scissored-tailed swallow is the most classic design. It symbolizes good fortune and joyful tidings. Different colors also have small variations in meaning.
Are these commonly understood meanings and symbols in Liyue? Kind of like the language of flowers in Fontaine.
I believe so. Most have probably heard something about it from their elders at some point. If you're interested, Miss Charlotte, I have several books on the topic that I could lend you. They could be a useful reference.
That's nice.
That would be a huge help! Great! Looks like I've got the outline for quite the article on my hands.
Perfect! We're gonna take a look around!
Then I'll show Miss Charlotte to my home for a little while.
Okay.
I almost forgot. The Ministry of Civil Affairs is hosting a kite flying contest on the night of Lantern Rite. If you're interested, you're more than welcome to bring a kite and participate.
The rules
are simple. Whoever flies their kite the highest and furthest within the time limit will receive a special honor along with a secret prize.
Ooh.
I've already prepared more than enough empty film for the event. I can see the spectacle already.
We'll be there.
Oh, Paimon was on board the moment you said secret prize.
Then I'll look forward to seeing your performance.
You bet! See you then!
See you there.
Wait, Trevor? Take a peek to your right. Do you see those two people lurking over there? Is it just Paimon? Or were they staring at us the whole time we were talking to Kuching and Charlotte just now?
I agree.
Great! So it wasn't just Paimon. Do you think they could be treasure hoarders? They always seem to be stirring up trouble during Lantern Rite.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, Paimon, sick of waiting around for something bad to happen. We should strike first, you know? Foil their plans before they even begin. You go right, Paimon will go left.
Wait, Paimon. This is it. The part one. So, if we check, we are done already. Or... go to the quest. Okay, we can still continue. We will go to a certain area. The suspicious person.
Oh!
It is with such an air of urgency that you appear before us. Your comportment suggests you believe us to have committed some heinous crime. Perhaps you could enlighten us as to your intentions.
Wow, where did this fuddy daddy come from? You should be the one doing the enlightening, buddy. Don't think we didn't notice you eavesdropping. One look and we could tell you were up to no good. Tell us everything, starting with your name.
One bears no secrets before two such as yourselves. You stand in the presence of the mighty and illuminated Adeptus.
What?
Moon Carver.
What, Moon Carver?
For the purpose of this foray into the mortal realm, however, you may address one as Hojong.
Hojong, okay. So this is Moon Carver, guys.
You kidding? That deer's got his head stuck so far up in the clouds, there's no way he'd humble himself down here with the rest of us.
You may want to hold your tongue.
Paimon is gonna believe you just because you know her name. But Paimon, guess you're supposed to be Mountain Shaper, right?
Indeed. Mooncarver and myself have descended upon the mortal realm for a visit. The two of you may call me Jihou.
Jihou.
Ah, looks like you did your research. But in our experience, the harder you try to lead us on, the more likely it is that we've got a big fish on our hands. We'll go straight to the Millilith and have you arrested for impersonating a deaf guy!
Preposterous! Utterly preposterous!
Perhaps you can prove it?
Right! Tell us something that only an Adeptus would know. And it better not be some common knowledge that any person on the street could tell you.
You may recall that in order to preserve the tranquility of one's mountain, one planted karst crawlers around Mount Hulao. In fact, the seeds are one of Streetward Rambler's cultivars. Among all the Adepti, her horticultural skill is preeminent. The plant neither wilts nor withers, and its practical use is undeniable. Yet it does require quite the upkeep. After a while, one tires of the effort. Thus, one had no choice but to foray into town to inquire from Streetward Rambler a gentler and more easily managed
variety.
On your way, you were accosted by a group of youths, and without revealing your true form, were unable to extricate yourself of their presence. If one's memory serves, Streetward Rambler had to personally come to your rescue.
How did you come into possession of such knowledge?
The young lass, Yao Yao, keeps no secrets from Cloud Retainer.
Alas, one can only let bygones be bygones.
I suppose they really are the Adepti.
That might have been more detail than we needed. Seems like you two are the real deal, and Paimon, sorry for suspecting you. But, for beings as forgiving as yourselves, this is just water under the bridge, right?
Take it as a compliment to the quality of your disguise.
You indeed have an agile mind. Cloud Retainer was not mistaken in her high estimation of you.
Paimon's still curious about something. It's just... Paimon can understand why Mountain Shaper is here, but why did you decide to come to the city, Mooncarver? It's not really your thing, is it?
It is but an inevitable eventuality. Long have the mountains remained strangely idle since Cloud Retainer's move to Liyue Harbor. With Lantern Rite near at hand, one would expect Cloud Retainer to provide us with an account of the festivities in advance. Yet to this day, she has failed to appear.
Oh, I see.
Cloud Retainer is hardly the forgetful sort.
One must never rest idle in the face of that which demands action. And since our acquaintances dwell in Liyue Harbor, we had to travel here in human form to avail ourselves of their aid. Cloud Retainers, in this case.
But a moment ago, one heard you speak of a mechanical kite of sorts. It appears the essence of the situation has hitherto revealed itself. Now, it is time for one to retire back to one's abode.
Huh. So, you're not looking for Cloud Retainer anymore?
Perhaps there are aspects of Cloud Retainer's temperament that remain opaque to young Paimon. Given one's understanding, one can only imagine the anger that now consumes her.
Cloud Retainer is of a proud and arrogant disposition. She holds the belief that her skill in mechanics surpasses that of all others. One can be quite certain it is hardly with an open mind that she regards the arrival of this new technology.
One surmises that she has shut herself away, refused all company, and buried herself in the study of her own creations. To call on her would only invite her rebuke. However, if you do happen to cross paths with her over the next few days, do pass along one's regards.
Sure, leave it to us! Have a safe trip back, enjoy the scenery, and happy lantern ride!
Thank you for your kind words. We shall now depart.
We got all worked up for nothing, huh? All that trouble, and it turned out to be people we knew all along!
Yeah.
Well, it's still pretty early. Let's head over and check out the kite stuff. Paimon wants to see what kinds of kites we can buy to use in the competition. The bigger and prettier, the better!
Okay, here we go. So we're going to proceed to a kite store.
Welcome! Are the two of you looking to buy a kite? Would you like me to go over the different designs?
Ooh! A scissor kill swallow! And a butterfly! And...
This jade chamber design is our newest. It's been selling like crazy over the past 2 days.
Does it also have a unique meaning?
Of course. The jade chamber symbolizes wealth and abundance. The kite bearing its design is said to bring riches in the future to those who fly it.
Oh, now that's Paimon's kind of kite!
I apologize for the interruption, but are all your wares in order, Miss Genuine?
Genuine?
Yes, they're just over there. The paper, bamboo, and dyes. All the necessary kite-making materials.
Wonderful! I'll pack them up and get a guard to deliver the goods to Yilong Wharf for you.
Yilong Wharf? Oh, wonder what that place is like during Lantern Rite. Paimon would love to go take a look.
Well, if the two of you are interested in going to Yilong Wharf, then could I trouble you to find Gaming and deliver these goods together?
Well, no. Going to meet... Gaming.
Is Gaming
for the first time,
you just mentioned?
I think.
Well, yes. The communications office handles shipments and transports around Liyue. He works for the Secure Transport Agency, one of our sub-organizations. The problem is, many of my colleagues have taken leave during Lantern Rite to spend time with their families. So, our available workforce has seen a dramatic decrease recently. If you
dramatic
were willing to
decrease.
Help out, then I could get a head start on my next appointment.
You do seem really pressed for time.
We'll help.
Wonderful. You will, of course, be compensated for your efforts. Now, at this time of day, Gaming should be somewhere in the vicinity. But just follow the main road until you see the head of a Wusho dance costume. Should be on your right.
Be sure to come back if you'd like to buy a kite. I'll even give you a discount.
Hey. So it is. I'm going to the next task. Follow the instructions to find Gaming. And that is... Okay, just a few more meters.
Wait, I thought we had an agreement. Loser buys dim sum tomorrow? Look at you, scowl like that for much longer and your face might stay that way. Hey now, don't be upset. How about this? You extend the invitation, and I'll pay.
No way, Gaming. You're always the one picking up the tab. I'm not trying to be a sore loser, I just didn't expect you to come from behind to win like that.
That was nothing. All in a day's work, friend.
Perfect! Gaming is here!
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt, Gaming. We just spoke to a guy from the communications office who needs you to deliver some goods to Yilong Wharf.
Oh! That must have been Longzhou. Looks like I've got work. Gotta go.
Sure. Go do your thing. Let's have a rematch when you get back. I won't let you win so easily next time.
Alrighty, you can hand the goods over to me. Must have been heavy hauling them all this way. Let me take them off your hands.
It wasn't that bad. It's just some kite-making materials. Plus, we didn't have to walk very far.
Kite-making? making materials. I see, I see. I'm glad it wasn't too much trouble, Paimon. Still, I owe you one. Ah, and you must be the traveler. It's nice to meet you. Thanks for your help.
Huh? You know us?
Oh no.
There probably aren't many in Liyue who don't. I've heard quite a bit about you two. You're quite well known around these parts. Oh, and please excuse Longzhou if he forgot to thank you. Take my thanks in his place. He's a good guy. He's just been super busy lately, running around from place to place. Don't be too hard on him, yeah?
No worries.
So, you here for Lantern Rite?
Yep. It's always so lively this time of year. We were actually hoping we could tag along to Yilong Wharf and have a look around.
Perfect. We'll go together then. I'm good with directions, so just follow me. Trust me, I know my way around. We can exchange stories, tell jokes, or just chat along the way. Oh, and there are a couple of good places to eat along our route. We can stop and grab a bite when it's time.
Hey.
The ingredients are fresh, the portions are generous, and the prices won't break the bank. You can order anything, and I promise, you won't be disappointed.
Order anything?
Paimon seems to be drooling around already.
Did you really have to call Paimon out like that in front of our new friend?
Don't worry, I understand. I joke around like that with my friends, too. It just shows how close you are. Do you need to pack anything up before we hit the road? I can wait.
Oh, no.
Our things are always packed and ready. We're pretty much travel experts at this point.
Oh, that's right. Then let's get going. If we run into any trouble, you can count on me to protect you. I am a guard, after all.
Where is it? So introducing Gami, right? Oh, that's nice. Introduction. How this lantern right? Oh, so this is the new event. So I guess we are done with the introduction, right? So vibrant harriers aloft in the spring breeze. So we're done with the chapter 1, I think. So let's exit. I think that is Festive Affairs, right? Yep, we are done with Festive Affairs. Of course, we can proceed there if we want to. But of course, there are side quests or side activities throughout part 1, part 2, and part 3. So Paper Shadows, a forging. So we have another quest for Paper Shadow Ruminations. So I guess that's it for our introduction with our Vibrant Harriers Aloft in Spring Breeze. So yes, let's continue these activities on the next video. So thank you so much guys for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next video. So have a great day, one. Bye.